Hey guys, it's Nick. We all have a ton of manual processes that we're performing today, and it seems to be an ever-expanding list that we're keeping up with as well across all of our customers. And what I see a lot of today is specifically in the Microsoft ecosystem as well, because we have Active Directory, and with that comes a lot of change control and a lot of administrative tasks. A common example would be user onboard, offboard, which is an ever-expanding list as well too of the tasks that we need to perform for those individual users as well. And a lot of that's to do with the explosion of SaaS applications and entering the cloud, as well as the rise of remote and hybrid work. But what I see too from an MSP layer and a service model layer is that you're growing very linearly in the service team itself to be able to accommodate for the volume of tickets or phone calls that you're receiving about these common repetitive tasks, such as the change control with your user onboard or offboard, administrative tasks that relate to access controls, those types of things as well too. Where I feel like there's going to be a shift though in the next few years is that the service model is actually going to change, and we're going to have a partition part of that service team, which is specifically a robotic operations center, or ROC. Now, the ROC's sole job or sole responsibility is to take a look at all the mundane, repetitive, or time-consuming tasks that you're performing today and to automate them. So that's not to say you'll automate everything, but think about how much time and how much money you could actually save if a lot of the common processes that are absorbing a lot of the service team's time today are fully automated. Ultimately, it has downstream effects to the customer because they will be getting a better experience. And you can then focus in on what matters most, like improving that customer relationship or focusing in on sales to go get more customers as well. So I'm very excited to introduce a product called Rewst to you today, which is a robotic process automation tool that's specifically built and focuses in on the MSP space as well. So this is something I've been wanting to do for a while. I barely scratched the surface with Rewst, but it's a very powerful tool, especially with Microsoft 365 automation. I just want to give a quick disclaimer though that Rewst did not pay me to make this video. I'm not getting sponsored by Rewst whatsoever. I just think that their product is really great and wanted to showcase it here for you today, specifically around the Microsoft automation capabilities as well. I've done a lot of automation around Power Automate in the past, but this is purpose-built for MSPs. So really wanted to dive in with you today and give you some visuals as well. So let's go ahead and take a look at the platform.
Okay, I'm here within Rewst, and just to preface, I'm not going to be doing a deep dive of Rewst with you today. I'm specifically going to be focusing in on a high level of Microsoft and the integrations that they have here and the capabilities you have as well too. I'll link below a particular list of resources that you can use to reach out to Rewst and schedule a demo, those types of things as well too, if you leave this video wanting to learn more. So from within here, you have these basic connections to your partner center environment, which is Microsoft CSP, and then also Microsoft Graph. So you can use their APIs to pull in a lot of data or automate a lot of processes with Microsoft as well. And it masks a lot of the complexity here as well because of the pre-built integrations out of the box, which you'll be seeing as we walk through this video. But within here, if I click on Microsoft CSP, this brings up a list of all the organizations within my partner center. I can ingest them here within my environment, and I just have a basic test partner center. So I only have one customer here, but I'm able to grant them delegated admin consent as well too. So we can go through both a secure process for ingesting our customers, but also a convenient process as well. Because if you've ever done Microsoft 365 automation, you know, there's a lot of complexity that's behind the scenes with app registrations and PowerShell and a lot of complexity that you really have to have a whole knowledge hurdle over, really to get into the weeds as far as automating things across customer tenants. So that's pretty cool out of the box. And then additionally, you'll see here that they have this whole integration store with some of the most popular MSP tools out there, specifically your PSA tool like ConnectWise is in here, but they also integrate with the RMM side of the house as well, which is really powerful for even local Active Directory and being able to make changes there, which I'll show you as part of one of the workflows as well too. So a lot to unpack just in this of itself, but it's really cool that these are already baked in. If you've used Power Automate in the past, I've had to create a bunch of custom connectors like I have, you value this extremely because they're not only building the connections and handling the authentication, but they are also going in and giving you a list of APIs to tap into or actions that you can tap into that you don't have to go look at the API docs, you don't have to learn all the JSON. Like there's a learning curve here that's significantly reduced by using this tool. So just wanted to highlight that as well too, as we talk about, you know, the masking effect that, that this happens here, especially around Microsoft, because multi-tenancy and getting access tokens into downstream customer environments, again, is a significant learning curve, which is basically all done behind the scenes with Rewst as well. Next here, I also wanted to show, as you're getting acclimated to the tool, they have what's known as a crate marketplace, which is effectively a marketplace of a bunch of pre-built automations that you can leverage. And it's really more of the no-code side of the house. When we talk about low-code, no-code, because they've already built the entire automation workflow on the back end, and you just have to supplement it with certain variables, those types of things. But some of these in here are also community driven. Like this MFA reporting was driven by a community member who's using the tool today. And so they work heavily with MSPs to be able to publish these within the environment. But it's really great because it gets your feet wet with a lot of these things. Or if you're not real versed in all the back end activity that you need to do to chain these workflows together, you can at least have something that is very human readable for the regular user who's not very as technical, I would say, as well too. So I just want to reference that as well too, because this is a great way to get started. I personally use these to just understand how things are working in Rewst as an example. And I know Microsoft really well, so I was able to connect the dots as well there too. So once you add some of these crates as well too, you'll be able to access workflows within the workflow section, which is truly the automation that's going on. And some of these are built as part of the general workflow that you've set up, or general crate that you've set up in the past. So a couple of these here, I think, are common great examples of things that maybe are really repetitive today, very much not needing a high-level technician to go in and do these things, like resetting a user's password, for instance. So if you were to look in here on this workflow, you can see that this is just a canvas view of everything going on. And I can just scroll in and out to go ahead and see this as well. But it's really cool because you can see that it's starting the workflow. It's going and getting a contact within your PSA tool. And then it's performing all of these other tasks here that are sometimes sub workflows, those types of things. That's reaching into both Active Directory, if you are on-prem, if you have an ARMM integration here as well. And then it can do, obviously, Azure AD as well too. And so we're leveraging these Graph API calls within the environment, but we don't have to know all of them particularly, because they have this library, again, of all of these particular tasks that are pre-built out of the box with Rewst as well, that you can just simply drag and drop onto the canvas. So if I want to say update user, I can just drag and drop this into the canvas, and then I can connect it directly from within this workflow as well. And then I can customize all the various fields that might go into this as well too. In this case, it's an update user, so I have parameters to define like their basic contact information that you can see here too. So it's a pretty cool way to go ahead and chain automation events together. It's a pretty great visual to have as well too. Obviously, this can start to look like a big bowl of spaghetti as you get more and more into the workflow itself, which can be overwhelming. But I would say that, you know, on the forefront of all this, you have the ability to add those crates again to get a better visual of things going on. And this is a lot more intuitive when you think about an MSP mindset than something like Power Automate, because of how purpose-built it is for this audience. And it kind of masks things that you used to have to do manually in Power Automate. Specifically, I experienced this a lot, and I was ultimately just, my learning curve was going through what's not actually a Power Automate function and those types of things within here. So it's really cool to see this as well. And this is also obviously integrated with multiple tools, but within the workflows that I've built, I also built one specifically to go look for disabled users and then just remove them from all the groups within the organization. So this is a pretty basic one, but I'm just getting all the users in Microsoft, and I'm filtering out to just get their ID, their principal name, and their account being enabled or disabled. It's a Boolean value. And then from there, you know, I'm able to store the disabled users by using some code in here to say I just want the ones that are in a disabled state. And then from there, I'm just pumping that into a side workflow here, and I'm just opening this up in another tab But all this does, it goes and it lists the groups for the users, and then it removes the users from those groups. And so there's some additional filtering here that I've done and some asterisks to this because there's a lot of caveats with Microsoft groups and dynamic groups and those types of things as well. But this was a very simple flow for a common use case that we have as well, where users, when they're offboarded, they're disabled, but they're not necessarily removed from groups at that point in time. So they still show up in the list when other users are searching for them, which creates some confusion or opens up more tickets, those types of things as well. So it's pretty cool to just have this capability with a couple of little tasks that I've, or actions that I put into the canvas here, that ultimately automate that whole process for us. I think the other cool thing is in the triggers here, as in whenever you want this to run, you have a ton of triggers here, and some of them specifically are for the PSA tool, but we do have some here for Microsoft Graph. And within there, you know, this could be a lot of just webhook activity that we want to know or understand, like risky user, right? As a common example of something that's really significant to know when there's a new risky user, and then to either create a ticket in PSA, do some automated investigation that populates into the PSA ticket. I think the most overwhelming part of Rewst is the fact that it's so open for the capabilities that you have. It's just about what do I want to go do first at the end of the day. That's, to me, where I'm stuck a little bit. It's like my creativity is going in 1,000 different directions because of all the things that you can do. But specifically in here, you could also do a cron job, which is basically just saying, hey, I want to run this every day or every hour or whatever it might be. There as well too. But this down below here is also some of the cool aspects that is really geared toward the MSP, as in this is purpose-built for multi-tenancy. So within here, I could have this run for one-to-many organizations. And remember, again, I just have a test tenant in here, but you could have all the partner center customers that you manage within here, and you could dictate, you know, I want all of these to be applicable to this particular workflow, or just a couple that I define as well too. So it's pretty cool as far as the ability to trigger these workflows as well. And additionally with that, you are able to do it based off of a form. So forms in Rewst are pretty unique in one way specifically, which is really powerful as well, which I'll show you guys here as well too. These are forms that you can introduce into your customer base. I'm not going to save any changes there. But effectively here, if I go take a look at like this new user creation form that's pre-built from Rewst, again, this is part of what's in their Create Marketplace, I can go in and I can see that obviously they're using similar things that we're familiar with, like form fields that we can drag and drop and define here as well. But some of the cool aspects of it, or the really powerful aspects of it as well here too, is that you can dynamically grab information from within the Microsoft tenant, or even if it's on-prem, if you have your RMM connected here as well, you can go and reach in with the PowerShell scripts that they built to grab all the users from Active Directory, and that's a local Active Directory. So it's a really powerful experience, and this is what you can put in front of your end users as well, just so that they can go ahead and dynamically choose the active groups within the environment. They can choose, you know, in my example here, I'm using security groups, but these are the groups within my tenant that I've connected here, which is my T-minus tenant as well. And then the other cool part is you have like the entire available versus assigned concept of the licenses. So you can see all that here, and you could see technically if there's no more used or no more available, like business premium, if I wanted to order that as well. And with the onboarding workflow, just to go a step further, they integrate with your common distributors who might be providing these licenses like Pax8 to go in, and if there's no licenses left, they'll actually reach into Pax8, order the license, wait for it to provision, and then go back to assign it to the user. So it's accounting for so many things here that, you know, ultimately give us hours of work to go do or take hours to get completed because of all these various caveats. So this is the form that's out of the box for user onboarding, and it's totally tied to a backend workflow that will automate every one of these processes as far as creating the user in PSA, creating them in Microsoft, giving them a license, adding them to their particular groups or Teams channels, those types of things as well too. And you can ultimately define what a company has access to or what field would be applicable to them through what's called organizational variables. And I'm not going to get into that today because it's a different rabbit hole to walk down. But effectively, at the end of the day, what I'm saying is that you can customize this on a per customer layer, and they have a unique URL that they could hit, or you could embed this, you know, in a certain location so that they can go ahead and fill out an onboarding form that's completely automated on the back end. Or you could say, if it's not all automated, push in what we didn't automate to the ticket, right, at the end of the day. So a lot of great opportunities there for those aspects of the automation. And within here, as far as the workflow goes, you can also visualize that new user or new employee onboarding as well here too. And this is where I'm saying, you know, you have a lot of tasks going on here, which is very intimidating to view. And think about all the logic that's really going on behind the scenes with this. But again, this is why it's in their marketplace. This is why it's already pre-built, is so that you don't have to think about all this complexity. You can just add, you know, the human readable concepts or specifics about your company, like what PSA do you use? What documentation tool do you use? What distributor do you use? And, you know, then just have this work behind the scenes. And they have a really great support system as well too. They have a lot of knowledgeable employees and the whole Discord that's really active in supporting you as well too. Again, I kind of feel like a salesman right now, but I really think this is a great product, and I just really wanted to showcase it for you guys, because a lot of automation can be done within Microsoft. And ultimately, just based off of my own experience with trying to automate with PowerShell and Power Automate, this is so much better, or so much more streamlined for the average MSP and everything that you can potentially do because of all the integrations as well.
Okay, guys, that's everything I had for you in today's video. Definitely a lot to unpack with Rewst. There's a definite learning curve that you have to go through. I don't want to make this seem like it's all easy to do and you can just set up a ton of automations in a few minutes. You definitely have to invest your time into the tool and have a team around it, I believe, as well too. But that investment is going to pay off largely at the end of the day as well, just based off of all the ROI you can get from all the manual processes you're automating. And again, to come back to where I said in the beginning, it's ultimately going to transcend the value down to the customer because of the experience, because of the efficiencies that you're deriving for them, and just the overall professionalism that you can show from a technology perspective. Like I was saying, I've barely scratched the surface with Rewst myself, but we are building a whole team at my MSP to be able to accommodate for Rewst and all the automations internal to our organization. So it's definitely something we're going to spend a lot of time with, and I'll be coming out with more videos over time just to show some of the Microsoft automations that I'm building as well, just to give you guys more examples, or even maybe hopefully share those with the community in the future as well too. So as always, go ahead and comment below with any questions about this video or Rewst, and like and subscribe if you guys want to see more content around Microsoft and the MSP space. Thanks guys, I'll see you next week.